Dear students, welcome to DACJ Home Classes, our digital initiative by Directorate of School Education, Jammu. I am Jyoti Diwan. I am going to teach you an essay, The Rule of the Road by A.G. Gardner, Class 12th, Chapter 16th. Dear students, I am very happy to be here with you once again. Let us start with the introduction of the writer. Alfred George Gardner was an English journalist, editor, and one of the most popular essayists of 20th century. He was born in 1865 in Chelmsford in United Kingdom. His essays are uniformly elegant, graceful, and humorous. His uniqueness lay in his ability to teach the basic truth of life in an easy and amusing manner. The present extract is from Leaves in the Wind. In this essay, Gardner says that in life, rights and duties go side by side. We should protect our rights as free citizens, but our personal liberty should not meddle with the liberty of others. Man is a part of society to which he belongs, and he should always realize his social obligations. The rules of the road. At their simplest, traffic laws are to prevent drivers of vehicles from causing accidents or hitting pedestrians. They are also to help control the flow of traffic. The essay is about how much liberty can we use when we walk on the road. Dear students, now we read in detail. A.G. Gardner, in his essay, The Rule of the Road, points out what constitutes the true liberty. He begins by giving an example of an old lady who insisted on walking in the middle of the road, in Petrograd, instead of on the pavement. Her argument was that she had got liberty now to do so. She didn't realize that, like her, the cab driver was also entitled to drive on the pavement. If such a thing happened, there would be traffic jams and yaws everywhere, and nobody would be able to reach his or her destination in time. Such an individual liberty would result in complete anarchy in society. The author thinks that these days, people are increasingly getting liberty drunk, which is very dangerous. Therefore, we must understand the rule of the road. It means that in order to preserve the liberty of all, the liberties of everyone must be curtailed. The traffic policeman should be taken as a symbol of liberty and not of anarchy when he is controlling traffic. Some curtailment of private liberty is necessary so that everyone may enjoy a social order that makes liberty a reality, because liberty is not only a personal affair but also a social contract. If a person's liberty doesn't affect others' liberty, then he can sew as he likes. For example, he may wear the type of clothes which he likes, wear shoes or walk bare feet, support long or short hair. He can follow his fancy by going to bed late or getting up early. He need not ask anybody's permission in such things. But the moment his personal liberty begins to affect others, then it must be restricted. He may play his musical instrument as loudly as he wants if it doesn't disturb his neighbors. But he should ensure that his actions don't encroach upon the liberty of other people. The author gives another example of a person who entered a railway carriage and disturbed him with his loud talking when he was trying to read Blue Book. The man talked commonplace things with his friend in a loud and pompous voice, and forced the author to stop reading. The author didn't object lest he should be considered a very rude fellow. He feels that a reasonable consideration for the rights and feelings of others is a foundation of social behavior. He is of the view women are less civilized in this respect than men. The reason is that men are better trained than women in give and take of social relationship because they have lived more in broad current of the world. They have learned from their school life, their club life and games. But now women are beginning to enjoy these things. The writer believes that the rights of small people and quiet people are also important to preserve. Motorists have no right to disturb others by blowing their horns deliberately and noisily. Similarly, one should listen to his gramophone inside his house, maintaining privacy and not disturbing his neighbors. The fact is that we can be neither complete anarchists nor complete socialists in this complex world of ours. We must be a reasonable mixture of both. We must preserve our own liberty and our social liberty as well. This can be done by observing the rule of the road. In life, great moments of heroism and sacrifice are rare. So, only the little habits of social behavior can sweeten or make our life bitter. Now, let us read the theme of the rule of the road. In On the Rule of the Road by A.G. Gardner, we have the theme of liberty, frustration, equality and control. Taken from his Leaves in the Wind collection, the reader realizes after reading the essay that Gardner may be exploring the theme of liberty, both personal and social. Gardner finds it difficult when an individual's personal liberty campaigns on the liberty of the majority and gives the case of the old women walking down the middle of the road. The woman has every right to walk where she wants. However, in turn, a bus or car has a right to drive on the pavement. The result, as Gardner suggests, would be obvious chaos and anarchy. There needs to be some boundaries put in place to ensure that a person's personal liberties don't impinge on others. What is also interesting about the essay is that Gardner may possibly be suggesting that when it comes to personal liberties, an individual has to be receptive of others and not impose on the personal liberties of others. The example with the trombone being a perfect example. Gardner also argues that liberty is not a personal affair but more of a social contract, a contract between the individual and society. The woman in the middle of the street, for example, may feel she is doing nothing wrong, yet she is possibly causing injury to not only herself but to others too. Should the bus driver or car driver invoke their personal liberties and drive on the pavement? As mentioned, the result would be yours. It is for this reason that the individual has to take into consideration how others might feel, something that the man on the train doesn't do. He becomes a frustration to Gardner because Gardner is unable to read his book, just as there has to be rules for traveling on the road. Likewise, society needs rules when it comes to an individual's personal liberties. One can't simply do as they please for their own enjoyment or rebellion. By doing so, they will inevitably become outcasts or worse victims to the law. Liberties, after all, as mentioned, are a social contract between the individual and society. At no stage can an individual's personal whim be allowed to dictate as to how others might feel. Each man and woman is equal and answerable to adhering to the same social contract, regardless of their social standing or their income our trade. Each person is equal when it comes to the issue of liberties, something that is not necessarily understood by the minority of society. Also, an individual who breaks the social contract will not only frustrate their neighbors, but will also become an outcast, just as a man or woman who walks down the street in unusual attire may. Though in this case, the individual has right to dress as they see fit, they may, however, not recognize the consequences to their actions. In reality, the individual is not necessarily free to do as they wish. There is a limit to what they can do. One is never completely free to do as they please. There is always a consequence which may or may not be worth paying. Dear students, let us have a look at how Gardner deals with the question of individual liberty in this essay, or the understanding by the concept of liberty. Gardner is not against individual liberty where others have nothing to do with it. For instance, a person is free to put on a dressing gown. He is free to have long hair or bare feet. Another person has a liberty to laugh at him, but he has a liberty to be indifferent to him. A person can have a fancy for dyeing his hair. He can wax his moustache or wear a tall hat. He can put on a frock coat and sandals. He can go to bed late or get up early. In all such matters, an individual can follow his fancy and need not ask anybody's permission. He needs not ask another person whether he should eat mustard with mutton. My becoming a Protestant or a Catholic has nothing to do with another person's liberty. An individual has a liberty to marry the dark lady or the fair lady. He may prefer Ella Wheeler Wilcox to Wordsworth or Champagne to Chandigarh. In all such matters, we have the whole kingdom where we rule alone. We can do what we choose. We can be wise or ridiculous, harsh or easy, conventional or odd. There are personal things in which a person can enjoy individual liberty. Every individual can decide where his child should study. It is for him to see whether his child should specialize in science or arts, whether he should play roger or soccer. From all these examples, it becomes obvious that individual liberty can be enjoyed fully as long as it doesn't interfere with another person's liberty. Dear students, the writer says, individual liberty leads to social anarchy. Do you agree or disagree? Give reasons for your answer. The answer is here. I agree with the view that individual liberty leads to social anarchy. If every individual does what he wants, others' liberty will be endangered. The old lady walking down the middle of the road was asked to walk on the pavement, which was meant for foot passengers. She insisted on walking where she liked. She thus got everybody else way and caused social anarchy and confusion. Our liberty of action has to be restricted by other people's liberty to ensure that we don't cause social anarchy. Liberty is not only a personal affair, but a social contract too. If we ignore others' interests, they will ignore ours. This will disturb the social order. Dear students, see, why should we not feel offended when stopped by a traffic policeman? We should not feel offended because a traffic policeman is not a symbol of tyranny, but of liberty. He is there to curtail the liberties of some to ensure that the liberties of all others are preserved. If we drive as we like, there will be traffic chaos. The traffic policeman is there to allow smooth movement of traffic and passengers on the road. The writer describes the old woman in the middle of the road being of no small peril to herself. This means she was in the dangerous frame of mind. She was running the risk of being run over by the traffic. She was about to run over people on the road. The answer is she was running the risk of being run over by the traffic. As I wrestled with clauses and sections, his voice rose like a gale. Who does he refer to? Once the writer got into the railway carriage and began reading a blue book as a task, he therefore needed a reasonable quiet. At the next station, a couple of men came. One of them talked loudly to the other for the rest of the journey and disturbed the writer. He refers to the man who thus disturbed the writer. Dear students, we will explain the words impede your path. It means to block or obstruct your advancement in action, activity or speech, etc. Means apna rasta thopna. Explain turning an honest penny out of them. This means that the writer wants to get all the information from the blue book by reading them in an undisturbed atmosphere. Thus, he will get everything worth the money spent in buying them. Means book buy करने के लिए जो उसने money spend किया है उसका पाई पाई वसूल करना. Another question is, what is a blue book? Why does he read them? A blue book is a book containing official records. The writer reads blue books in order to gather information from them. This requires a serious reading of them and so a peaceful atmosphere around. The essay, The Rule of the Road, is an extract from, the answer is, Leaves in the Wind. One word substitution for one who plays a game for pleasure and not as a job. The answer is amateur. Dear students, here are some words with their meanings and opposites. Ayaz, meaning is confusion and the opposite is order. Peril, meaning is danger and opposite is safety. Anarchy, meaning is lawlessness and opposite is discipline. Liberty, meaning is freedom and opposite is bondage. Curtailed, the meaning is reduced and the opposite is enhanced. Aggressive, the meaning is pushing and the opposite is timid. Impertinence, the meaning is impudence and the opposite is civility. Violated, the meaning is encroached and the opposite is respected. Pompous, the meaning is affected and the opposite is natural. Impediment, the meaning is hurdle and the opposite is help. Now we come to the conclusion of the essay, The Rule of the Road. Liberty means responsibility. Swatantrata ka arth hai zimmedari, a reasonable consideration for the rights or feelings of others. Is the foundation of social conduct. It's the little habits of commonplace intercourse that make up the great sum of life. It sweetens our life's journey. We should fulfill our responsibility towards society and live happily within our limits, following the basic rules from traffic to society. Dear students, follow every rule from the road to your personal life and become a good citizen. God bless you.